Hello students,
now we are going to discuss the anomalous properties of carbon. In the group 14, carbon shows some different behavior compared to other elements. The properties of carbon and its compounds differ from the other elements and their compounds. Generally, the first member of the group always shows anomalous property. Already we have discussed what are the cause of anomalous property of carbon. Causes is first one is small size, high ionization energy, high electronegativity, and absence of vacant d orbitals. Mainly these four points are very important. Due to this, carbon showing different nature compared to other elements. What are the anomalous properties? Anomalous property, first one is it is the hardest substance. Hardest compared to other elements. Almost other elements are soft, but this is the hardest. Then high melting and boiling point, high MP and BP, both high melting point and also boiling point. Maximum covalency of carbon is 4. Maximum covalence of carbon is 4, but other show greater number. What are these? For example, silicon shows SiF6 2-. Here covalency of silicon is 4. SiOH 4 6 2-. It is also covalency 6. Higher covalency also observed in case of other elements because they have vacant d orbitals. If the elements have vacant d orbitals, as d orbital, d subshell contains 5 vacant orbitals. So the covalency will be generally more because the paired electron can be converted to unpaired by shifting the electron from lower energy level to higher energy level, lower subshell to higher energy subshell. That's why silicon shows higher covalency, germanium shows higher covalency, but carbon cannot be due to absence of vacant d orbitals. And another important thing is carbon cannot form CH2 halides. Dihalides of carbon is not possible, but lead can form in lead dichloride, tin, SLN dichloride is possible. Dihalides of other elements is possible, but carbon is not, because C plus 2 is unstable. Does not exist. That's why dihalides of carbon is not possible. Only produce tetrahalides. Tetrahalides, carbon tetrachloride, is not easily hydrolyze. Is not easily hydrolyzed, but silicon tetrafluoride can be hydrolyzed. For example, you can write CCl4 cross water, here no reaction. There is no reaction between water and carbon tetrafluoride in the simply pure some water, because this lone pair is not accepted by carbon because carbon has no vacant d orbitals. But silicon tetrafluoride or water here is forming a substitution reaction between here water molecules. Here water molecule donates lone pair to silicon and it produces substituted silicon tetrahydroxide. It is also one acidic character. So carbon tetrachloride is not easily hydrolyzed, but silicon chloride can be easily hydrolyzed. Carbon produces monoxides and dioxides like others, but CO is neutral and CO2 is acidic. But others are amphoteric character. Almost all dihalides of elements, germanium, tin, lead, that silicon also, silicon, germanium, mainly amphoteric character, it reacts with acid and reacts with base, both. And carbon monoxide is neutral. Here no, that only monoxide of carbon is neutral, but there is no neutral character of other monoxides of these elements, germanium, silicon and your lead, that is no, they do not show the neutral character, generally show amphoteric behavior. So carbon produces monoxides, and very important thing is here, important point is carbon dioxide is gas and carbon monoxide also gas, but others monoxides and dioxides or monoxide dioxides are solids. This is a very important difference. Almost all monoxides and dioxides of germanium, silicon and higher members, all are solids, but carbon shows only gaseous monoxides and dioxide. Carbon dioxide, carbon monoxides, all are gaseous. So this is one important that anomalous property. Carbon shows catenation property. Carbon shows catenation property. Catenation nature. Catenation means your very strong CC bond, stronger CC bond. But other elements do not show catenation property because due to weaker MM bond. Others weaker. For others, weaker MM bond. Other bonds are weaker bond. But carbon-carbon bond is stronger bond, that's why shows catenation behavior and forms. It forms multiple bond it forms, that is C single bond C, C double bond C, C triple bond C can be possible in case of carbon. But other elements, this multiple bond formation is not possible because the pi bonds are very weak in case of higher member of this group elements. That's why it forms multiple bonds. Carbon tetrachloride is not easily hydrolyzed, but silicon tetrachloride can be easily hydrolyzed because carbon has no vacant d orbital, that's why it do not react with water. Carbon produces monoxide, dioxides and all are in gaseous state. And carbon monoxide is neutral, but carbon dioxide is acidic. But other dioxides of this group elements shows amphoteric character. It can react with acid and base. Already we have discussed in the previous lessons. And carbon show catenation nature. This property is not shown by other elements because the other elements, the MM bond is weaker bond. This is the important difference between the properties of carbon which differ from the other elements. If you write the reaction also, that we will discuss. For silicon dioxide, you see silicon dioxide with the hydrochloric acid produce silicon tetrachloride and water, and this silicon dioxide reacts with sodium hydroxide for the sodium silicate and water. So like this, your PbO2, PbO, both PbO and your SnO, SnO2, both these here, PbO2, PbO2, all are amphoteric. It can react with acid and base. But in case of carbon dioxide, it is high, it is acidic character. It reacts with only base, forming carbonate. Already we discussed this thing in the previous lessons. Carbon dioxide, only acidic character, reacts with base, forming sodium carbonate and water. This is the property, acidic property of carbon dioxide. Okay, so these are the anomalous property of carbon which show different behavior compared to other allotropic forms. It exists in allotropic forms. The allotropic modification is possible in case of carbon, but other generally they do not show allotropic form because it forms multiple bond. Multiple bond is possible in case of carbon. That's why it shows different allotropic forms. What are the allotropic forms? What are the allotropes of carbon? Diamond, graphite, fullerene. Fullerene is carbon 60. That is called fullerene. And coke, charcoal, lamp black. These are the allotropes of carbon showing different behavior. Already you know, you have read in junior classes, your graphite is good conductor, diamond is bad conductor, and fullerene is very stable. Allotropes of carbon and other allotropes of carbon is coke, charcoal, lamp black, like this. So they have different structures, that's why they are showing allotropic modification due to formation of multiple bond, which is possible in case of carbon. That's why carbon shows allotropic modification. Okay, thank you all.